Hey guys, today let's take a look at the famous Warangal Fort in India. This is one of the strangest ancient sites. At first look, we can see thousands and thousands of rocks cut in various shapes, strewn around all over this site. I mean, you can literally find any geometric shape you want in the site. This is extraordinary stonework. When you hear the name Warangal Fort, you expect to see a fort or fortifications or crude walls. But here, you will find some of the most beautiful carvings. This was definitely not built as a fort. A fort does not need such beautiful artistic carvings and complex geometric shapes. Historians also agree that this site is not a fort, but they merely call this a fort because it's surrounded by fortifications many miles away. But they have no idea what the actual purpose of this place was. Why do we have so many rocks piled up? And in these piles, we can also find some of the most exotic Hindu gods lying in the dirt. These statues are priceless and are actually worth millions of dollars in India. You can see they're just left lying around in the dirt. Because we find several idols like this, some have argued that this site was built as a temple and it was later ruined. Was this site once an ancient temple, and was it ruined by nature or human beings? If you examine the site carefully, you can find something weird. There are at least a dozen different types of rocks. This is redstone, this is black basalt, and this is granite. This is bizarre because if a temple was built with a combination of all these rocks, it will just look ugly. All Hindu temples are usually built with the same type of rock. It would be impossible to use so many types of rocks for constructing a single temple. And the entrances to this site confirm that this was not a temple. The entire site is surrounded by four different entrances, which are just incredibly huge. They are each 33 feet tall. There are no walls surrounding it either. This is very unique. A temple does not need such tall entrances, and Hindu temples always have an outer wall around them. If this was not a temple and this was not a fort, what was going on here? What was the actual purpose of the site? No one has come up with a solid answer to this question, but after analyzing this place carefully, I can say this entire place was built as a manufacturing site, as a factory for mass manufacturing megalithic stone objects. Now, what I'm saying goes against all the theories of archaeologists and historians. They believe that every temple was built locally by local artisans and stonemasons who cut stone blocks and carved statues on site within the temple premises. But Warangal Fort shows something extraordinary. It shows that the pillars, statues, and even blocks for walls were built at a completely different location, a mass manufacturing site. This was the purpose of this site. Look at these rectangular blocks, for example. There are hundreds of them. They have the most amazing geometrical patterns, and each one is different from the others. What are these rectangular blocks? If we visit the temples around this area, you will realize that these blocks are actually centerpieces of ceilings in Hindu temples. All Hindu temples have these blocks fixed on top of the main deity. There is usually one such piece in each temple, and we find hundreds of these ceiling pieces in this site. This proves that these pieces were created here to be transported to hundreds of different temples. Look at all these blocks. Do you see what they are? This is just scrap left over from mass manufacturing, just like how we get scrap metal from a metal processing company. And the location of the site confirms this. Warangal Fort is located at the dead center, and hundreds of temples are built all around it. This information is stunning because it shows that whoever built this civilization had extraordinary intelligence. This kind of planning, logistics, and implementation does not even exist today in India. Having a central manufacturing site at a perfect location to transport finished stone blocks to all the temples. This is fantastic. But the question is, why? What is the need to have a central manufacturing site for just temple parts? Why can't they just cut stone blocks and carve statues on the temple site itself? Now, why do we mass manufacture anything? When we need a car, why don't we build our own car and let the car company manufacture it? Because mass manufacturers use advanced machining technology, which you and I don't have. This is why mass manufacturers exist. Is it possible that Warangal Fort was also using advanced machining technology? Is this why they were able to create thousands of these temple parts? I mean, look at this lingam. Is it possible to create it with chisels and hammers and just primitive tools? Take a look at these ceiling parts. They look incredible, but if you pick any one of them and try to explain it in words, you understand how complex these blocks are. For example, this one has a protruding bud in the center. Note that it also has 8 small petals ready to come out on top of it. The bud is sitting on another small circle and is surrounded by 3 perfect circles, which are concentric, and they all have many petals carved on them. All these circles are placed in a perfect square, which fits inside a perfect rhombus, flanked by 4 small squares, and everything is fit inside this bigger square. And this is all done in 3 dimension. This is not painted on paper. There are so many protrusions and depressions. If you look at these flower-like patterns, I mean, they look amazing from the top. But when you look at them from the side, they actually look like petals coming out in 3D. And if you touch these petals, it can literally cut your fingers. That's how sharp the finish is. It is impossible to do this with primitive tools. We have clear evidence of drilling technology on this site. They must have had drilling tools to accomplish this level of drilling. And how do we explain these minute holes found in these carvings? Look at this polygonal lingam, which is in ruins. Observe the sides and the finish on the surface. And look at the bottom. Was it really made with primitive tools? Take a look at this pillar. You can literally use this flat surface as a mirror if you pour water on top of the surface. If I give you a chisel and hammer today, can you achieve this level of polishing? And look at this lattice work. This is called Jali in India. We have people who insist that these were created using geopolymer technology, even though we believe that this technology was invented only in the last century. Whether these are geopolymers or rocks, one thing is certain. Ancient builders were definitely using advanced machining technology, and Warangal Fort was the mass manufacturing factory. They were mass manufacturing these pieces and then transporting them to various locations of the temples, and whoever designed this entire setup must have had very high intelligence. I keep saying whoever because archaeologists and historians establish something very clearly. There are no inscriptions on the site, and the origin of Warangal Fort is shrouded in mystery. Some people think it was built by a dynasty called Kakatiyas, but we have solid evidence that this structure predates these rulers by centuries, maybe even by thousands of years. Nobody really knows who set up this ancient manufacturing site and how long it operated. Did we once have an ancient civilization with advanced technology, which was eventually wiped out? The people who came here after many centuries merely inherited these stones, and they must have had very limited knowledge because they actually tried to put these pieces together and build structures. Here you can see how they've pieced the ceiling blocks to make a wall. This was not a good idea, and obviously you can see why their attempts failed. Not to mention the Islamic invader, Alauddin Khalji, who invaded this place. His army tried to deface each and every stone block which had human or animal figures, but I think he simply could not finish the destruction. This is an elephant, but now it looks almost like a pig. And experts confirm that the invaders also took many of the rectangular stone blocks from here and built this structure called Kush Mahal, which is just half a mile away. The human beings in the 12th century had very limited intelligence. They were pretty much like us. They had wars, looted and damaged everything, and they just thought that these were pieces of a temple that needed to be put together. The advanced civilization was definitely far more advanced. We can literally see this by looking at their machining technology. These circular parts cannot be created without lathe machines. Look at the perfect circle, but then look at it in 3D. Look at the turning and the steps of the structure. This cannot be created without lathe machines. In a previous video, I showed you an ancient lathe setup lying in the dirt in Hampi. And look at this square slot in the center, and look at the identical slot in Warangal Fort. All these parts were created in lathe machines and then assembled with these pillars in various temples. All these pillars, which are fully assembled in Warangal Fort, were put together by the archaeology department. There are also solid monolithic pillars, exquisitely carved, lying on the ground. They have beautiful designs and deities carved on them. And we can also see independent statues of animals like this lion, for example. This is my personal favorite statue here. It looks like it was molded, just like how we melt and cast plastic items. Now, remember, we saw so many varieties of rocks. These rocks, like granite and black basalt, are very hard rocks, and basically, you would need a harder material to cut them. Today, we use diamond-tipped tools. Were ancient builders using diamond-tipped tools? I mean, how did they make such precision cuts? The hardness of the rock is so important, it would be impossible to cut such hard rocks with simple tools. I think all this is clear proof of lost ancient technology and high-tech machining, and confirms that Warangal Fort was built as a mass manufacturing factory. What do you think? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I am Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and also click on the bell button to get all the updates. Please give this video a thumbs up and do share it with your friends. And I'll talk to you soon.